changes. In the year 1945, my great-great-grandfather, serving in the army, wondered when he'd get to go home to his wife and the son he'd never seen. He got his wish when the U.S. ended World War II by dropping atomic bombs on Hiroshima and Nagasaki. The world awaited Armageddon. Instead, something miraculous happened. We began to use atomic energy not as a weapon, but as a nearly limitless source of power. People enjoyed luxuries once thought the realm of science fiction. Domestic robots, fusion-powered cars, portable computers. But then, in the 21st century, people awoke from the American dream. Years of consumption led to shortages of every major resource. The entire world unraveled. Peace became a distant memory. It is now the year 2077. We stand on the brink of total war. And I am afraid. For myself, for my wife, for my infant son. Because if my time in the army taught me one thing, it's that war never changes.
Hey, boy.
Hi.
What's going on?
Can we chat?
Sure.
Your thoughts?
A trader in Quincy had a dog named Ziggy who would follow us on the road sometimes. He'd walk with us up to University Point, and then he'd turn around, pick up the next caravan heading south, and go back home with them. He was a great dog.
What's on your mind?
Would you take me to University Point? I need to go there, but I can't stand the thought of going there alone.
Calm down. Just tell me what's going on.
I can't tell this story more than once. If I promise to tell you everything once we get to University Point, can we go? I need this. Please. I don't want to go alone.
Of course I'll help you.
Thank you.
That's all.
Wishing that
Your thoughts?
Looking good.
Hey. Your thoughts?
Gotta keep it up.
Mission set is active.
Hey. How you doing, buddy?
Hey, boy. You know any tricks?
Want no raiders, mutants, death cult, robots, or Marler queens. Doesn't matter, we don't want them. They live right here. atom bomb, baby, you're my atom bomb. I want you, my little one. You're just the way I want you to be. A million times harder than TNT. Worry, 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 there's a death claw out there. Worry, 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 there's a raid everywhere. Worry, 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 where is he?
Whenever I see a place like this, I always wonder, what was it like before the war? You know, to live there? that.
New location discovered. Bingo. Nice.
Oh, I see you every night, babe, and I'll hear you every day. I'll be your regular mama, and I'll put that gun away. Oh, someday, lay that pistol down.
chance against...
Best sleep
the
ever.
The Ken's effects are expired. Stay back. You showed them.
Location discovered.
Hey there.
Check your fire. We've got hostiles.
describe Halen?
Abominations!
Excuse me.
Damn skinbags!
Check your fire. You've got hostiles.
Appreciate the assistance, civilian. It's your business. Really? In that case, let me ask you some questions. Are you from a local settlement?
I'm from Sanctuary Hills, on the other side of Concord.
I've seen the location on our maps, but I've never visited the area myself. There isn't much over there for us to collect. If I appear suspicious, it's because our mission here has been difficult. Since the moment we arrived in the Commonwealth, we were constantly under fire. We want to continue pitching in. We could use an extra gun on our side.
I'll continue to help, but you owe me an explanation first.
My paladin tells you, prepare to describe him and night Reese. We're on recon. I've been trying to send distress calls to security. The signal's too weak to reach them.
Sir, if I may.
Proceed.
I've modified the radio tower on the roof of the police station, but I'm afraid it just isn't enough. What we need is something that can reach the signal.
Our target is targeting systems. It contains the technology and a deep-range transmitter. We infiltrate the facility, secure the transmitter, and bring it back here. So what do you say? Willing to lend the Brotherhood of Steel a hand?
Who are the Brotherhood of Steel?
Our order seeks to understand the nature of technology, its power, its meaning to us as humans. And we fight to secure that power from those who would abuse it.
How did mankind abuse technology?
Before the Great War, science and technology became more of a burden than a benefit. The atom bomb. Bioengineered plagues and FEV are clear examples of the horrors that technological advancement have wrought. We're here to make sure that never happens again.
So you steal technology and keep it for yourselves?
You're implying that we do this to benefit ourselves. I can assure you our motivation is quite the opposite. So, what do you say?
It's a good plan, if we make it back.
I can assure you that I wouldn't undertake this mission unless I had confidence in your abilities. Halen, take Reese inside and bind his wounds.
Yes, sir.
Reese, once you're on your feet, I want you to make certain the perimeter is secure.
I'm on it.
All right, civilian. It's time to prove your worth. Head to the police station and resupply yourself. Then let me know when you're ready to begin. Let's move out.
All right, big guy. Go.
Yeah.
Unit level increase.
Oh, you better get a move. It's not a good idea to keep Howard and Dance waiting.
New mission objective received.
Is one hell of a squad leader. I don't know what we'd do without him.
Halen?
Don't take what Night Reese says personally. He's like that with everyone.
You gonna patch me up or what?
I don't know. Your prognosis looks pretty grim. Might be more humane to just take you out back and shoot you.
You're all heart, Doc.
Just quit squirming so I can get these bandages on. Sorry about the other guys.
Why are you cutting me so much slack?
I joined the Brotherhood not too long ago. I used to be like you. Wandering alone. So I know what it feels like when every single person you bump into sticks a gun in your face. Look, it may not seem like it, but Dance is a good man. He's just all soldier. Protocol? This is bread and butter. And Reese? Well, let's just say he's as hard-headed as a Mr. Gutsy. But you know what? I'd trust both of them with my life. Because they're good people. And that's hard to come by nowadays.
Why are you standing around here like there's nothing to do? Paladin Dance is waiting for you.
Excuse me.
Feral squash pretty good when you stomp on their heads in power armor. Oh man, I love that sound. Been stuck out here too damn long. I'm itching to see some real action. Helen might only be a scribe, but she can kick some serious ass. I wouldn't mess with her if I were you. Dropping muties and ferals is my specialty. And since? Hell, they're just extra target practice for me.
Scribe Halen, personal log entry 324A. I'm starting to wonder if joining the Brotherhood of Steel was a good choice. I originally signed up seeking protection and comradeship, but I'm worried that I've traded away a bit of my humanity in the process. The Brotherhood's message of hope for the future is idealistic and noble, but their methods leave a lot to be desired. The leadership seems especially misguided. Instead of diplomacy, they wield violent confrontation to exert control. Despite all that, I've been successfully avoiding the fighting by following the career path of a field scribe. I suppose only time will tell how long I can stand the sight of spilled blood over my own moral fiber.
Perfect. Bingo.
Hello, team. Captain Widmark here. Welcome to the task force. Operation Winter's End starts now, with you. Together, we will knock Eddie Winter off his throne and dump his sorry ass in a 2,000-volt easy chair. It should come as a surprise to no one that our operations in Boston have been, in a word, compromised. Winter has eyes everywhere, even the BPD. So, our brothers across the river in Cambridge have been kind enough let us use the Cambridge Police Department as our base of operations. Let's get to work. Good hunting.
Dance.
You ready to move out?
Why establish an outpost at the police station?
Given the nature of the facility, we felt it would be tactically advantageous to search it for weapons and ammunition. The radio tower on the roof was an unexpected boon, but it obviously has its shortcomings that need to be rectified. It might not be as imposing as the Citadel back in the Capital Wasteland, but it suits our purposes. That's all I'm willing to divulge at this point. Are you ready to proceed with the mission?
Ready.
Outstanding. Follow me, and try not to lag behind. We'll take it. Follow me. Up to me, I'd relocate my team.
Wait there.
Lost contact with them. They haven't been heard from since. As far as my team goes, we've lost four good men to this godforsaken wasteland. Been a target from the moment we arrived. Despite our setbacks, I don't intend to give up and head home.
location discovered.
Paladin dance.
Keep moving. Double time it.
Come on. This way. Pick up the pace. Time's wasting. Listen.
Dance
up.
Reminds
we
me of my mom.
Clean.
Same badass
no
attitude.
Heroics and by the book. Understood?
Why are we at ArcJet again?
We're here to retrieve a device that will boost the signal from the radio tower at the Cambridge police station.
Without it, we can't make contact with our superiors.
Remember, our primary target is the deep range transmitter. Stay focused and check your fire. I don't want to be hit by stray bullets.
Excellent.
Why the heck are they making us record this? Oh crap, it's on, isn't it? This is Technician Rand, ArcJet Propulsion Division. I'm here with Technician Janowski, work log A1190. Janowski and I have been working on the Mars Shot project for about 3 months now, and I think we have the thrust calculations worked out.
Man, I wish I was headed up there with those guys. Be nice to get the hell away from our lousy planet.
Hey, easy. If we don't record these logs properly, we're gonna get fired. The supervisor is already itching to get rid of us, especially since it's taking us longer than we promised.
So what? We've been drafted anyway. We're shipping out in a few weeks, remember? Soon we'll be doing push-ups, eating freeze-dried rations, and just wishing we were spending our day inside a cushy private laboratory.
Of course I remember. But I'm trying not to imagine getting my head blown off when I'm on the front line, and keeping my mind on work is helping me deal with the problem. Maybe that doesn't make sense to you, but it's important to me, okay?
All right. I'm sorry. Look, why don't you toss this tape, and we'll start a new one.
Interesting.
Where are there so many?
Yes. That's it. Got it. Bingo. Sweet.
Hey. There we go.
came through. Paladin.
Keep the noise down. This place is crawling with hostiles.
Hell yeah. Excuse me, Paladin Dance.
All right, get your corners and keep it quiet. Nice. Hey.
Mm-hmm.
Got it.
Engine core power restored. Thermal engine fueled, primed, and standing by for your command. Three. Two. 1. Engine firing. Completed with an efficiency rating of 96.7%.
We killed so many synths. That was amazing. You did good.
Bingo. Hey.
Dance.
Enough, Jen. Let's go.
dance.
No time for questions now. We have to keep moving.
Hey, over here. Hey. How you doing, buddy?
Well, that could have gone smoother, but mission accomplished.
Smoother? I thought we did fine.
That sweep was sloppy. We were caught unprepared more than once, which is unacceptable. However, your extra gun gave us the edge we needed. I'm not certain I could have accomplished the mission alone.
I thought we worked well as a team.
Agreed. It's a refreshing change to work with a civilian who can follow orders properly. That being said, I believe we have two important matters to discuss. First and foremost, if you'll hand me the deep-range transmitter, I'd like to compensate you for your assistance during this operation. I think you'll find this weapon useful. It's my own personal modification of the standard Brotherhood laser rifle. May it serve you well in battle.
That isn't necessary.
I insist you keep it. The Brotherhood believes in paying all of its debts. Now, as far as the second matter goes, I wanted to make you a proposal. We had a lot thrown at us back there. Our op could have ended in disaster, but you kept your cool and handled it like a soldier. There's no doubt in my mind that you've got what it takes. The way I see it, you've got a choice. You could spend the rest of your life wandering from place to place, trading an extra hand for a meager reward. Or, you could join the Brotherhood of Steel and make your mark on the world. So, what do you say?
So, what would be expected of me if I joined?
You'd be under my command, and I'd expect you to follow orders. No more mercenary work. This is the real thing. You'd have access to advanced military weapons, as well as your own personal suit of power armor. Most importantly, you'd have the Brotherhood at your back. Ready to spill its own blood to keep you alive. Offer still stands. Can we count on you?
I don't know.
It's a big decision, so I understand your hesitation. If you decide you want to become one of us, you know where we are. Good luck.
New mission objective received.
What's going on?
Can we chat?
I'd like that.
Your thoughts?
When we were little, there was a trader in Quincy named Taylor who would organize Halloween for all us kids. Taylor would give each of us one of those little plastic pumpkins to carry and got all the traders to put out candy and toys for us to collect. One year, I got so many wooden blocks I could spell my name.
What's on your mind?
You know, my parents were Brotherhood. They were from California originally. Traveled to the Capital Wasteland under Elder Lions. At some point, they fought with Lions and left. Dad said they abandoned Lions and his bad ideas, not the Brotherhood. I always had the feeling they wanted to go back to California. But they came here instead. Closer, you know, less dangerous trip.
Being cautious, not a bad call.
My mom was a paladin. She's the one that trained me with weapons. She wasn't gonna have a kid that couldn't handle herself. She died a long time ago. My dad's a scribe.
Were your parents... were they good to you?
Yep, took great care of us when we were little. But then my dad just decided to leave one day.
Did you ever ask him why?
Yeah, but he wouldn't give me a straight answer. He might have left because my mom was gone. You know, grief can make people do some weird shit.
That's all. Hey. Over here. Hey. Wait there.